Hello and welcome to a new math video. In this episode, I will explain to you how a straight line in space can be expressed with the help of an equation. A straight line consists of infinitely many points, and we want to encapture all of them with our equation. To determine the location of a point in space, a coordinate system is used. Since we are working with three dimensions here, we need a three-dimensional coordinate system. We call these three axes x, y, and z. It is also common to call them x1, x2, and x3. But how do we reach every point on this straight line using a mathematical description? From the point of origin, we could, for example, reach this point with a vector, but also this point with another vector. So we can pinpoint any point on this straight line position vector. And if we generally call all points x, then their position vectors are simply called vector x. This can be described as a set. However, a list of infinity many vectors pointing from the origin to our straight line does not really help us now. But we can use this very list and simply select one vector that points from the origin to our straight line. Let's just use this one right here. The point we reach with this vector is now given the name A, for example. Since it points from the origin to a point A, we simply call it a connection vector and abbreviate it with OA. To keep things short, the position vector of point A is often called capital A instead of OA. Note that these names aren't fixed. For example, you could also name this vector small a or something else like Jack or Smith or whatever comes to your mind. The only thing important to understand here is that this position vector takes us from the origin to a starting point on our straight line. And from there, we can reach any other point. If we want to reach this point here, we need a connection vector from point A to point X. Since our connection vector points in the direction of our straight line, we call it a direction vector. Let's just name it V, but every other name is also fine. Consequently, the equation to reach our point X would be vector A plus direction vector V. To spice things up, we modify our equation to reach any point on our straight line. Starting from point A, I have to walk the length of my direction vector two times to move to this point here. In our equation, all we have to do is to add our direction vector twice to the point A. By the way, this also works in the opposite direction. For example, if I want to reach this point, I simply walk my direction vector in the opposite direction. In our equation, it looks like this. Our point A plus minus one time our direction vector. But now we want to express with our equation that we can reach any point on this straight line. To achieve this, we just multiply the direction vector by a letter instead of a concrete number. Take k for instance. K can assume any real number. And since the real numbers are complete, we can use this equation to determine any point on our straight line. Instead of k, I can use any letter such as L or R. Very commonly Greek letters are used like lambda or mu. So please don't get confused if this parameter is not called k or lambda. We now have an equation that we can use to pinpoint every point on our straight line in space. In the next video here, I will show you some applications of this topic. Thank you for watching and goodbye.